Hi, some time ago I published a video on how to use gas sensors with Arduino, and I'm still getting questions about it. People ask me how to calibrate the sensor and get the readings in parts per million, that is ppm units. Today I'll try to give you some answers, but I will focus on the MQ-2 gas sensor. If you haven't seen the original video, it's a good idea to watch it first. You can jump to it by simply clicking the card in the top right corner or using the link from the description. Let's see what we can do with the MQ-2. This little guy can detect LPG, I-butane, carbon monoxide, smoke, and a few others. If you hook it up to an Arduino and use my sketch from the original video, you'll get values ranging from 0 to 1023. The higher the value, the higher gas concentration it depicts. The problem is, it doesn't represent any standard unit and cannot be converted easily. There are two solutions I can think of. One of them involves a calibration kit, which consists of a gas tank, a regulator, a flow meter, a dryer tube, and more. This special equipment may cost hundreds of dollars or more, and it requires some knowledge to use it, but if you calibrate your sensor properly, the readings will be as precise as you can possibly get. Let's assume you don't want to invest such amounts of money and time to calibrate a $1 sensor. There is quite an easy method to do it by using a piece of Arduino code produced and shared for free by a company called Sandbox Electronics. Let's see how we can make it work. First, you need an MQ-2 and the Arduino setup from my previous video. If my sketch works properly, you can go to the Sandbox Electronics page and copy-paste the sample code section to your Arduino IDE. Now you can change the load resistance value in the code, which represents the load resistor on your board. During my tests, I was getting the best results with resistors close to 5 kiloohms. The last step is to upload the code to your Arduino. When you open the serial monitor, you will see the sensors calibrating for about 25 seconds, and during this period, it should be exposed to clean air. After that, the sensor is displaying the readings for LPG, carbon monoxide, and smoke, all in ppm units. That's all there is to it. This approach is quick, easy, and free, but be aware that your readings are calculated approximately, so they won't be as accurate. To make the values more consistent, you can preheat the sensor, which means leave it on connected to the circuit for at least 24 hours. It's a one-time process, so you don't have to repeat it later. Go ahead and try this calibration method yourself. If you like this tutorial or find it useful, please share it so more people can watch it. Consider subscribing so you won't miss my new videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time.